particular briefing session, which was to mediate debate around transitions towards performative learning and teaching. And in particular, he was keen for us to sort of bring the diversity of views from around the world to the table, both in terms of reflecting on the current state of pedagogy. I think we certainly have representation from Ireland, the UK and Germany here, but also vast amounts of experience in the room amongst the previous speakers of working in the US, working on European policy, working in Asia as well. So I think what we'd like to hear from each of you is your current view of the state of play in terms of pedagogic practice here and around the world, but also what in your view is, where do we need to go now, which is the question that Manfred put to us in the early part of the session. So maybe if we start with the spectators who were sitting around watching the initial session, and if it's okay with you, I'll start from the left, which is where I like to start. So to my left, and I'm sorry, Vaṣen.
Well, I want to speak about theatre in schools in Germany, and I will read some aspects because my English is not so good, and I can only mention the most important aspects of theatre, drama, and teacher training in the context of developing a teaching style and personality as a teaching method and as an artistic aesthetic subject. Second, teaching methods based in acting and theatre. Regardless of which subject he or she has learned to teach, every teacher should also learn methods that draw on theatre and acting for use in putting together lessons in keeping with the educational principles of the particular subject. Whether in German, modern foreign languages, history or humanities, role-playing, acting out everyday situations in still images, etc., are increasingly being used today in combination with other methods to impart teaching content. It is exactly such shifts between methodologies that usually determine the quality of lessons.
In terms of, I cannot speak for the whole of the United States, it's just too big. I live in the Midwest, in a state, Indiana, that most people from Europe don't really know where it is. Some actually US Americans are not quite clear either. In terms of schools and colleges, universities, yes, some schools have drama clubs. Yes, university has theater departments, some really good theater departments, but not necessarily a interdisciplinary connection in terms of performative learning. I mean, I'm glad you mentioned Eisner and Maxine Green. I went just for curiosity's sake, I went online and Googled performative teaching and learning USA. I came about like a dozen articles dating from maybe 2007. I have them all somewhere. But the thing is, none of them was from the United States or Canada. Five were from the UK, and one was from Australia. Now, I know that at this conference we have 7 people from the United States and 4 people from Canada. And I just wanted to say to you, we obviously have our work cut out for us. We are cutting edge.
Back to the slides at the beginning when you were all smiling. The National Forum slides. I guess what we need to do is to seize any opportunity we can get to bring to the attention of policy makers, various fora, what mileage there is in the kind of work we are doing on a day-to-day basis. And so that's why I thought when I saw the opportunity to apply for this, why not? Because this way we signal to everybody, this is important work, and this needs to be supported further, and hopefully it will come to a point that we will see it reflected more in the policies also here in Ireland. I'm happy to see that a lot of has happened, especially at this university. Teaching and learning has really a profile now in this university, and so there are very encouraging developments, and maybe in a few years to come, who knows, there might even be more intense discussions around drama as a subject in primary schools and secondary schools, etc. So we have to keep up the momentum and stay at it and just work away as usual.
Manfred was pointing at his watch, so I'm not sure we have time to open up to the floor afterwards. But I think all of what you're saying, I hope you'll carry it with you through the rest of this this conference over the next few days, that whilst we're going through this whole process of reflective learning that's going on, to also start thinking about how we can share and build on some of the kinds of best practice that we've seen described in what Florian was telling us about processes in Germany, to think about the theoretical underpinnings to really support going forward with performative learning and teaching, and above all to start thinking about how we can influence policy and create platforms where we can sort of work together and work together. But thank you to all of you for participating in the session, and I think we all deserve a round of applause.